Patriots are traveling to a distant soil to take on the Aggies. Watch as a battle unfolds tonight as Sand Creek plays host to Britton Deerfield. High school basketball in Lenawee starts right now, only on LSN.
Davis bounced it off his head, and I don't think that was an accident.
We've got a tie atop the LCAA standings.
Count that baby in a foul.
The first time they've been there in 61 years. Morenci is going to the President Center.
And I think this is pretty much over.
Blissfield Royals, district champions.
Lenawee Sports and the Michigan High School Athletic Association proudly presents High School Varsity Basketball, where tonight the Sand Creek Aggies look to break 500. The Britton Deerfield Patriots, however, are looking for their ninth win of the season. And as always, it is part of the season-long race to our state championship. Good evening, friends. I'm Andrew Richard alongside Hannah Reckner. Britton Deerfield, 8-4 this year, having a great season so far. So, what do you think their mentality for tonight is?
For tonight, they want to play hard-nosed defense and lock down the Aggies at the three-point line.
And alongside with their keys of tonight, they want to have good transition, offense, and defense, and they also want to get out on the three-pointers quickly.
Their star players tonight will be Meg Bauer and Joey Langermeyer.
They'll have to keep Langermeyer and Bauer out of the paint because both of them can be very effective. So, we're going to throw it to Miley Alexander with the Britton Deerfield head coach.
Hey, thanks, guys. I'm here with Joel Scott, coach of the Britton Deerfield Patriots. What do you expect to see out of your girls on the court tonight?
Intensity, hard-nosed defense, and boxing out.
Sounds great, coach. How are you guys preparing for districts?
We're taking every game as a stepping stone where we want to get to our goal, but we can't overlook the hard TCC teams that are in our future.
Good luck, coach. Hope you do great.
Thanks. Great job.
Keep it right here. We'll be back to talk to Sand Creek's head coach after this. You're watching High School Varsity Basketball only on LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
The broadcast of today's game is a copyrighted presentation of the Michigan High School Athletic Association and the Lenawee Sports Network. No reproduction, retransmission, or other distribution of the descriptions or accounts of this game may take place without the express written consent of the MHSAA and the Lenawee Sports Network.
As the voice of Michigan student athletes, the Student Advisory Council's role
is to convey the message of how high school sports are supposed to be played.
We are responsible for helping the MHSAA maintain a positive and healthy atmosphere
in which interscholastic athletes can thrive.
We believe athletes should be competitive, sportsmanlike, and excel academically.
We believe students in the stand should have fun,
but not take the focus away from the game.
We believe coaches should act as teachers, helping student athletes develop
while still keeping high school sports in perspective.
We believe that parents should be positive role models and supportive of their child's decisions.
We believe officials commit their own time to high school sports,
and respect should always be shown and given to them.
The most important goal for student athletes is to enjoy high school sports
while keeping a high level of respect between all those involved in the games.
Enjoy the game.
Welcome back. Now we're here to talk about Sand Creek. What is the mentality for tonight?
So the mentality for tonight for Sand Creek is to get better for districts. They need to improve. They're 6-6, 500, so they really need to improve tonight and get something going, some momentum. So who are the star players for tonight?
They have a star group of seniors, actually, consisting of Brielle Startwell, Kaylee Benj, Megan Sarin, and Mackenzie Ream. They all need to step up to put Sand Creek back in playoff contention. What is the keys for tonight's game?
The keys for tonight is to box out and to keep their star players out of the paint, because they can be demolished inside the paint and really need to improve upon that.
Now let's go to Molly, who has Sand Creek's head coach.
I'm here with Coach Benj of the Sand Creek Fighting Aggies. What do you expect to see out of your girls on the court tonight?
I expect to see a really good start in the first quarter tonight. The last time that we played them, we did not start the game very well, so we've talked a lot about that this week. I expect to see a lot of communication tonight and some really good defense in the first quarter. That's my expectation.
Sounds good, Coach. With the season coming to a close, how are you preparing for districts?
We're just trying to grow tougher, Mile, every single game, because we know we got to play Madison in the first round, and so we want to be tougher defensively. We're kind of letting the offense take care of itself, but we're working on communication, and we're working on just getting stronger as a team, especially boxing out. It's kind of been our Achilles all year, is not boxing people out and giving them second shots, and we've lost some close games this year, so that's a huge thing for us in districts if we want to advance.
Sounds great. Look forward to seeing you fight for a district win. Thank you, Coach.
Keep it right here. We'll be back with the anthem and introductions after this. You're watching High School Varsity Basketball only on LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports.
There's just one place where students are students first, and athletics are played with purpose and perspective. That place is your local high school. High school sports offer more than the joy of competition. Studies show that student athletes are also likely to enjoy greater levels of achievement in other areas of their lives, including academics. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play or even what you wear. You just need to be there. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
We wanted to take an opportunity to honor our veterans tonight from both teams, both sides, of course. And I'd just like to read this to our veterans tonight. Servicemen and women who serve in wars often undergo great sacrifices. Some are killed in action, and some are badly injured. Even those who leave the military unscathed have had to endure sacrifices such as long separations from their families and putting their personal lives on hold. Honoring these veterans is a way for Americans to offer thanks for their sacrifices. And we need to do it more than just on Veterans Day. We agree with those who believe there's only one higher office than president, the American patriot. We also agree that our nation remains the land of the free because we are the home of the brave. We support all veterans and thank them and their families for sacrificing so that the rest of us can enjoy the freedom we have to play this game tonight. And we ask that those of you who are standing tonight to please come down and join your players on the floor tonight for the playing of our national anthem. So any veterans, Sand Creek veterans, join the Sand Creek players, and any veterans that are here tonight from Britton Deerfield, if you would please join your players tonight, we'd really appreciate that. Thank you.
The privilege of this game is made possible by these men and others who have fought and continue to fight for the freedoms we enjoy. Let us honor and respect our country by gentlemen removing their caps and everyone standing in attention, placing their hands over their hearts as we proudly sing our national anthem.
The tip-off is won by Sand Creek, number 21.
Pass number two, Brielle Startwell. Meg's cutting behind number 10. Screen's made by number 14, Mackenzie Ream, which is passed to her by Kaylee Bench for the layup.
Britton Deerfield bringing up the court, number 20, Megan Bauer. Megan Bauer dribbling up the court to number 25, Josie Scott. Jazalia Scott passes it out back to Bauer. Bauer trying to make some dribble moves out to number 23, Gotts. Gotts out to Langmeyer still up. Out to Bauer. Bauer trying to get something going here. Great defense by Sand Creek. Screen set by number 21, Loesch. Long mid-range shot is off as it will roll out of bounds. Sand Creek ball. Great defense by Sand Creek.
Number 20, Kaylee Benj will be throwing it in to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Brielle's making it down court. She looks down. There's back screen. It's made. Kaylee Benj, number 20, cuts for the ball, and Brielle Startwell passes it to her. Brielle cuts back for the ball, and Kaylee gives it back. Brielle starts dribbling. Now pass to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Kaylee Benj looks for number 10, Meg and Saren cutting. Kaylee makes a dribbling move, passes it back to number 14, Mackenzie Room. Junk ball called.
Great defense by both teams, really standing on their ground and not allowing anything. All right, we're going to throw it to break. You're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
If you don't fix them, sparks from dragging tow chains could cause a wildfire, and that could be scary. Only you can prevent wildfires.
All right, you're back at LSN. You're home for the Lenawee Sports as both teams having great defensive stands so far. Britton Deerfield almost turning it over, and now do turn it over to St. Creek.
Number 14, Mackenzie Reamill was dribbling it down, passed it to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Kaylee Benj looks for open players. She sees Mackenzie Ream making a cut. Kaylee goes on the outside and passes to number 2, Brielle Startwell, which passes it to Mackenzie Ream. Kaylee Benj for the three. Ooh. And cashes it.
A nice three by number 20, Kaylee Benj. Number 20 for Britton Deerfield. Megan Bauer bringing it up court. Out to number 34, Langmeyer. Getting forced to pick the ball up, but back out to number 25, Scott. Scott still dribbling up. Out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer dribbling up. Sand Creek playing very good defense. Langmeyer driving and is not getting anywhere. As it's a 3-second violation on Britton Deerfield as they turn the ball over again.
Number 20, Kaylee Benj will be passing it in to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Meg Sayer and number 10 and Mackenzie Ream come out, and Gracie Gallagher, number 15, and Grace Francoeur, number 30, come in. Brielle Startwell is dribbling down, looking for cutters to come up.
Ooh.
Now pass to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Kaylee Benj starts dribbling and makes a move. She looks for open players. She sees all the girls cutting. Timeout made by Sand Creek.
Okay. as we're going to cut it to break here. You're watching LSN. You're home for the Lenawee Sports.
Psst. They're coming. Please, is everybody.
Light check. 1, 2, 1, 2.
Everything looks good on our end.
And lights.
Come alive with the forest. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
And we're back on LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports, as St. Creek just turned the ball over, so now Britton Deerfield. No, excuse me. Britton Deerfield knocking it out of bounds.
Kaylee Bench passing it in to number two, Brielle Startwell. Brielle makes a dribbling move.
Stolen by number 34. Number 34 going to get an easy layup for Britton Deerfield as Britton Deerfield now leads 7-0.
Kaylee Bench threw it in to Brielle Startwell, who just dribbled past two of Britton Deerfield's players, passing it to Gracie Gallagher.
And it's blocked by Alcock.
Number Sand Creek turning the ball over.
And it will just roll aimlessly out into the locker room. As great, both teams playing great defense. As now it is Sand Creek leading 5-2 over Britton Deerfield so far. Langmeier into toss it in. Langmeier over to Alcock. Alcock for a mid-range shot, and it bounces in.
Kaylee Bench passing it in to number two, Brielle Startwell, running into trouble, which passes it back to Kaylee Bench, number 20.
Britton Deerfield playing a trap defense, full court trap defense. Wide open three for Sand Creek, and it banks off. Alcock with the rebound. Alcock into...
Brielle tips it.
Into Creek. As it's Bauer trying to blow past him, but can't blow past him. Bauer still up, number 25. Scott with it. Scott trying to find
Meg Startwell getting the foul called. Pushing
as
them
it's,
back.
As it's a blocking foul. Sand Creek picks up their first foul of the night. The first foul of the night for either teams, actually. Langmeier into Bauer. Bauer dribbling up top. Bauer, ooh, nice hesitation. Takes it out to number 15, Creek.
Brielle Startwell gained the steal and also drawing the foul.
So now that is the second foul of the night for both teams. And Sand Creek into inbound the ball.
It goes to Meg, which goes back to Brielle Startwell. Starting off the offense, setting it up.
Sand Creek leading 5-4 so far with 2:30 remaining in the first quarter.
Brielle Startwell makes a dribbling move, gets past both Britton Deerfield defenders and gets the layup.
Nice shake and bake move to the rim by Startwell as Bauer taking up court. Bauer picks up her dribble, looking for someone to pass to. It's out to Creek. Creek drives into Alcock, but it's stolen by Sand Creek.
Number 12, Hunter White, given to Brielle Startwell, number two. Brielle passes to Mackenzie Reed. Mackenzie Reed makes the move, and the ball goes out of bounds on Britton Deerfield.
With 1:54 remaining, Sand Creek leading 7-4 above Britton Deerfield.
Kaylee Ben rebounds it to Mackenzie Ream, which passes it back to Kaylee. Shot went off.
Britton Deerfield now taking it up court. Number 21 getting trapped. Loesch trapped, and
stolen.
It's stolen
by Brielle Startwell, number two. Brielle passes it to Kaylee Bench and goes off her fingers.
Britton Deerfield to inbound the ball. Into Bauer. Bauer taking up court. Bauer over to Langmeier. Langmeier looking for someone. Langmeier out to Loesch. Loesch over to Scott. Scott looking for someone. Great defense by Sand Creek. Pressing up. Although stolen, but it's Bauer inside to Loesch. Loesch draws the foul and one.
Foul number 12, Hunter White. Her first foul, Sand Creek second.
With 105 remaining, Brent Deerfield will start shooting free throws.
She gets one shot and 7-6. Sand Creek leading.
Loesch for the shot. It's up and it rims out.
Mackenzie Ream gets a rebound and outlets it to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Kaylee Benj dribbles down, setting up the offense. She makes a dribbling move, passes it to Hunter White, and Hunter White goes off, out of bounds. Patriots will inbound it.
Looked like a foul, but they did not call it. So Britton Deerfield to inbound it. Scott inbounds it to Bauer. Bauer now taking up court. Less than a minute remaining in the first quarter. Bauer driving, kicks it out to Langmeier. Langmeier in to Scott. Scott can't get it.
Number 20, Kaylee Bedge getting the rebound. Kaylee's dribbling it down court, hoping for a girl to open with 30 seconds remaining in the first. Giving it back to Brielle Startwell. Brielle looking to make a dribbling move. And travel is called. Patriots will pass it inbounds.
Loesch inbounds it to Bauer. Bauer taking up the court now. 15 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Bauer dribbling, 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 dribbling. Nice pass to number 34. Langmeier couldn't get it.
Brielle Startwell getting the rebound, making a dribbling move on number 21 of Patriots. Passing to Mackenzie Ream and...
The shot will not count, though. Hit the buzzer beater, but the shot will not count. As at the end of the first quarter, Sand Creek leads 7-6 as we're going to throw it to break, as this is LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
Everywhere that we go, he makes people laugh and makes people smile, and I feel like I have that quality.
He's the one who always takes me fishing.
I watch golf with him. And
I watch him cook, because when I grow up, I want to be a cook too.
We have the same faces like this.
Dad is the one, when you fall, that picks you up.
That unconditional sense of presence and reassurance is really what makes him my father.
May I please have an application? Thank you.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
You're watching high school varsity basketball only on LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports.
As right before the first quarter ended, both teams are playing great defense. Britton Deerfield trying to get into the paint, but Sand Creek really denying them so far tonight. Can they continue that? Britton Deerfield, it's Langmeier for a quick two to start off the second quarter.
Number 10 passing it in. Britton Deerfield throwing a trap, which...
It was slapped out of bounds by Scott as Sand Creek will retain possession.
Kaylee Bench passes in to number 2, Startwell. Startwell looks for the offense, to set up. She looks to make a move, passes to Mackenzie Ream. Mackenzie Ream goes up, and she scores.
Nice pass, a nice score by Ream, as Bauer now taking it up court. Bauer, some dribble moves, spinning off of number 10.
Saren's keeping her in front of her.
Bauer driving, floating it, no good.
Mackenzie Ream, number 14, getting the rebound, outletting it to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Brielle looks for the offense to start. Passes to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Kenzie Ream for the screen. Pass to McKenzie, and foul drawn.
Nice foul drawn, getting the shooting foul, so this will be Sand Creek's first free throws of the night.
Both teams now have two fouls.
Foul on number 21, Maggie Loesch.
Kenzie Ream, number 4, makes the first free throw, making the score 10-8. McKenzie will make her next one.
Scott inbounds it to Bauer. Bauer taking up court now. Up to Lagmeyer. Lagmeyer back to Bauer. Bauer trying to shake and bake, get to the hoop. Langmeyer in fake passes it out to Loesch. Loesch for the long two, and it banks in. Nice shot.
Number 12, Hunter White passes it in to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Brielle looks for the team to start. They're setting up a different play than normal. Pass to number 20, Kaylee Benj. Foul call, or
it's a travel called on Sand Creek. Britton Deerfield will retain possession. Scott to inbound to Bauer. Bauer now taking up court. Bauer trying to set up a play. Passes it to number 23, Goetz. Goetz will get the ball back. Out to Loesch. Loesch looking for someone. Will fake pass it to Bauer. Drives it, kicks it out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer now trying to drive. Picks up her dribble out to Goetz. Goetz for the long two, no good. And it's loose ball as Britton Deerfield will get the ball back. Langmeyer driving right into the corner, no good. Goetz passes it back out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer inside to Scott. Scott over. And she traveled. So now Sand Creek will get the ball back after a lengthy possession by Britton Deerfield.
Number 2, Brielle Startwell will throw it in to number 10, Megan, which is returned back to Startwell. Brielle looks for the offense as she dribbles down court. Mackenzie Ream goes up for the shot and is
foul,
blocked.
The foul will not be drawn, and now it is drawn for Britton Deerfield. Mackenzie Ream got pushed. So now Scott to inbound it to Bauer. Bauer taking up court now. Bauer tosses it in to Alcock. Alcock
is trapped.
Gets it out to Scott, but throws it away. Retained by Loesch. Loesch now driving out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer into Alcock. Alcock bodying Reen, but can't get it. Gets the rebound, puts it back up, and is fouled. Alcock to shoot her first free throws and the second free throws for Britton Deerfield total tonight.
That's Mackenzie Reen's second foul for this whole game.
Alcock to shoot her first free throw. Free throw is up, and it is no good. First one hits off.
Mackenzie Ream goes out with number 15, Gracie Gallagher come in. Megan Sarin goes out, number 10, comes in for number 30, Grace Francoeur.
Ream in early foul trouble that could trouble him down the stretch of the game. Ain't that right?
That's right.
Alcock to shoot her second free throw. Second one is up, and it is no good. So she misses both free throws.
Kaylee Benj gets the rebound, dribbles down court. She makes a dribbling move, gets past them, and a foul is called. Sand Creek will inbound it.
Foul on Joselia Scott.
It will be passed to Hunter White. Hunter White makes the screen, Kaylee Benj for the three, and it's no good. Grace Franco gets the rebound and goes back up.
No good. Rebound by Joselia Scott. Scott now taking it up to Bauer. Bauer now bringing up the court quickly. Bauer loses possession of the ball and it's stolen by Sand Creek.
Hunter White tips it to Brielle Startwell, which Brielle starts dribbling down the court. Startwell goes off the screen, looks for someone to get open. Almost loses the ball.
Great defense by Britton Deerfield.
Brielle looks.
No one's open. In the corner.
Timeout's made by Sand Creek.
As we're going to cut to break, you're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
The inherent right to work is one of the elemental privileges of a free people. Endowed, as our nation is, with abundant physical resources, and inspired as it should be to make those resources and opportunities available for the enjoyment of all, we approach re-employment with the real hope of finding a better answer than we have now.
Donate to Goodwill, where your donations help fund job placement and training for people in your community.
Life's taught me a lot, and I'm ready for more.
Well, you're not the typical kind of candidate that I hire, but you are exactly what I'm looking for.
Your company could be missing out on the candidates it needs most. Learn how to find a great pool of untapped talent at gradsoflife.org.
Okay, welcome back to LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports. As before the break, both teams fouling each other a lot, as right now there's 4 minutes remaining in the second quarter.
Very hard defense played by both teams.
Very close game. Sand Creek leads 11-10.
With 4:03 left in the second quarter. Kaylee Benj will pass it in. Kaylee looks for someone to get open. Brielle Startwell makes a move, but it's Grace Francor who will get the ball.
Bauer with the defense.
Pass back to number two, Brielle Startwell. Brielle Startwell makes a move and dribbles it off her foot.
She very, very costly turnover that could hurt them in the end. Scott to inbound it to Bauer. Bauer now taking it up the court. Bauer setting up the play. Bauer out to Alcock. Alcock over to number 15, Creek.
Real Startwell will grab it from behind, dribbling down court very great, quickly.
Great defense.
She stops, passes back to Kaylee Bench for the three, and it goes off the rim. It will go out on Sand Creek.
Britton Deerfield, good defense right there, but left Sand Creek wide open, and they have to capitalize on those three-pointers. They probably won't get much today. Bauer calling a play here. Bauer out to Langmeier, and it's tipped out of bounds by Sand Creek.
Number 30, Grace Brancourt, was the one who tipped it. Sand Creek looks to be setting up a zone. Yes, they are. A 2-3.
Creek inbounds it to Alcock. Alcock with the two. No good. Rebound by Sand Creek.
Number 30, Grace Brancourt with the rebound. Passing it to number two, Brielle Startwell. Brielle Startwell looks for a cutter. Makes a dribbling move and dribbles back out. Kaylee Bench flashes for a ball. Passes it to Kaylee Bench. Kaylee Bench will get the junk ball.
Great defense by both teams. Both teams playing good defense in the first half. Do you think they can continue that in the second half?
I do. I think whatever team sticks hardest with their defense is actually going to win tonight.
Defense
That's what it's going to come down to.
Defense wins championships. Sand Creek to inbound the ball.
Pass to number 10, Meg Sarin, which passes it back to Brielle for the three, and it's no good. It will go out of bounds.
Britton Deerfield holds them, leaving another wide open three, but like I said, Sand Creek needs to capitalize off of those threes because they probably won't get much after that. Bauer to take the ball up the court. Bauer, hesitation move out to Loesch. No, Creek, sorry, and throws it out of bounds. Sand Creek now forcing another turnover. Like I said, defense will play a factor in this game.
It will. Number 10, Meg Sarin will pass it in to number two, Brielle Startwell. Brielle will dribble it down court. Brielle looks to make a dribbling move. She goes around and goes for the three and cashes it. Brielle Startwell for the three.
Bauer to inbound it to Langmeier. Langmeier about to Bauer. Bauer going to take the ball up. Bauer looking. Out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer looking. Can't find number 20, Bauer, as Bauer couldn't get the ball, as Sand Creek forcing another turnover.
Number 10, Meg Sarin, will pass it in again to number 2, Brielle Startwell.
Scott in for number 15, Creek.
Number 20 and number 10. And 2, almost all the seniors are in right now. This is their star group of players. Hunter White tries to make it, but passes it back to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Brielle Startwell passes to number 14, Mackenzie Ream, which will draw a foul.
Reen has been doing pretty good on the boards lately, even though this team is pretty much outsized her.
She's small but powerful. That's 4 fouls for each team with a minute 27 left in the second quarter. Pass to number 14, Mackenzie Reen. Mackenzie Reen goes up for the shot and makes it. That's a 2-pointer for Sand Creek. Score 16-10, Creek.
Bauer taking it up court now. Britton Deerfield looking a little bit frustrated out there. Kicks it out to number 23 for the bank-in shot. What a shot by Gotts.
Brielle Startwell will dribble it down court. Offense looks almost already set up already, looking for a quick shot and good defense in the rest of the quarter. With less than a minute left. Brielle makes a dribbling move. Looks for a player. Meg flashes but does not pass it.
Nice screen set.
And we'll go out on Britton Deerfield.
On Sand Creek.
Sand Creek.
As Britton Deerfield gots to inbound the ball to Bauer. Bauer has played pretty much the whole game so far.
I think she hasn't taken a single break yet, except between the quarters.
Bauer taking up court, setting up a play here.
Only 20 seconds left.
Fighting for the ball as Britton Deerfield will retain possession.
Sand Creek will steal the ball again. Number 2, Brielle Startwell. Passes it to number 10, Meg Sarin, which passes it to 20. Kaylee Bench for the 3 and will not make it in. Hunter White for the rebound.
But she'll be out of bounds. So, 1.8 seconds remaining in the till halftime.
They want to try to roll the ball in, but Sand Creek's not going to let them.
So they're going to have to throw up a full court shot. Long throw.
And she crossed the line.
So now Sand Creek will get great possession right inside the territory.
They will get their ball in their own area with 1.8 seconds, left. They're looking for a quick shot. Perhaps a 3. It is shot by Brielle Starwell and will not go in.
So at halftime, Sand Creek leads 16-12 over Britton Deerfield. As we're going to go to break, you're watching LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports.
Hi, I'm Mike Rowe. 14 years ago, my mom was diagnosed with breast cancer. Well, this year, she celebrated her 50th wedding anniversary.
Is that why you've taken off your jeans?
No, I've taken off my jeans to prove the link between jeans and the fight against breast cancer.
Well, that's interesting. Do I have to take off my jeans?
No, nobody has to take off their jeans, Mom, but everybody has to go to denimday.com right now. I'll explain everything, dress code optional.
Apparently.
1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer. Learn more at denimday.com.
Smokey just gave me a bear hug.
Welcome back to LSN as Sand Creek leads Britton Deerfield in the half, 16-12.
So Sand Creek so far has started off better than we expected, as Mackenzie Reen has been a beast in the paint so far, has been clutching the free throws and what they needed them so far.
But Mackenzie Reen is running into foul trouble, so we'll have to see how she does in the second half to determine the game. Sand Creek does need to make their threes consistently to stay up in this game. with great defense, though, played by Britton Deerfield, which is shutting down their three-point shooters.
Sand Creek really needs to make those threes, like she said, and really needs to capitalize off of it because that will help them in the end and could really affect the outcome of this game.
Both teams, though, need to worry about foul trouble, though defense is what's going to make this game. So if their top defenders go out, the game will end.
And now we're going to cut it to Molly with one of the coaches.
Thanks, guys. Hey, Coach, let me know how you think that half went.
Probably one of our best halves defensively all year long. Remember I told you at the beginning of the game we wanted to come out and play tough, communicate. We did all those things right. So we got to play another tough half. They're a very tough team, but that's the kind of start we were looking for.
What do you plan to do in the second half to continue this redemption of victory against Britton Deerfield?
I tell you what, if we keep playing defense, we're going to be in the game, and hopefully we'll hit a couple of those threes. Usually we hit more threes than what we did, so if we can hit some of those threes and continue to look for Reem on the inside a little bit, pound it in a little bit, and play defense, we're going to be just fine.
Thanks, Coach. Great half.
Thanks, Molly. As we're going to talk about Britton Deerfield now. So Britton Deerfield has played some really good, solid defense of what they needed so far.
They'll still have to worry about foul trouble as Sand Creek, though Britton Deerfield's offense is actually rolling pretty good with how tough Sand Creek's defense has been tonight. Last time they played, it was not that tight. Tonight, Bowerman will have to stay out of foul trouble and still lead the offense, as that will be one of the keys tonight while keeping the key trying to get into it.
As Bauer has pretty much played the whole game, she's probably going to play the whole second half is when they need her because they're down right now. So we're going to throw to Molly.
Thanks, guys. Hey, Coach, how do you think that first half went for your team?
Not very well. We played ugly, couldn't execute, and our intensity level is way too low. We got to get that level up in order to win this game.
How do you plan to change that in the second half?
Well, hopefully I got to their heads through their butts there in the locker room, and hopefully they will respond.
Good luck, Coach.
Thanks, appreciate it.
This new dad is picturing a treehouse in the sky, but he's ignoring the instructions. Good luck, big guy. His kids know that he's building without a clue. Never been so good with nails and glue. Now we're trapped inside a box. I hope Mom knows what to do.
Mom!
See, you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
Connor is struggling in school.
Finding lowest airfare to Istanbul.
Why don't you understand me?
I do. This is what it feels like for kids with learning and attention issues. Redirecting to understood.org.
Welcome back to LSN, your home for the Lenawee sports. So, the second half is underway. Is what do both teams need to improve on?
Well, their defense is definitely going to have to stay the same, but their offense is going to have to start kicking up if they want to win this game tonight.
As Britton Deerfield with the possession now, Loesch out to Scott. Scott tries to throw it inside to Bauer, but it's tipped off a Sand Creek player. So now, Sand Creek now will get possession.
Number two, Brielle Startwell will be dribbling down the court. She's actually been their top ball handler tonight.
Echoing.
Brielle will look for an opening, making a dribbling effort. Looks for Kaylee Benj, which is passed to her. Megs Aaron makes the screens are actually being made by both sides of the girl. Kaylee Benj will make a dribbling move.
Britton Deerfield playing great defense.
Pass to Mackenzie Ream. Mackenzie Ream passes it to Megan, which Brielle hits the three.
Long three. And Scott to inbound it again, Bauer. Bauer going to take it up court now. Bauer trying to find some room. Langmeier now has the ball. Screen set by Scott. Three, no good.
Kaylee Benj will get the rebound, pass, dribbling it down court. Looks like she will set up the offense. Kaylee Benj makes a dribbling move, and it will go off her foot. Yep. It did go off her foot.
As Britton Deerfield will retain possession. As Britton Deerfield will now take a timeout. As we're going to cut to break, you're watching LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports.
Na, 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 na. I love you so. I love you. I love you. La, 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 la.
We're here. Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
This new mom is struggling to get the skates just right. Now she's holding on for dear life.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
Welcome back to LSN as Britton Deerfield has the ball now. A quick three by Langmeyer, and it will roll around and out, but rebound by Gotts. Gotts out to Loesch. Loesch dribbles, fakes, and now rolls around. Rebound Gotts. Gotts can't put it in. Rebound by Scott, and Scott now puts it in. Great rebounding by Britton Deerfield. Sand Creek nowhere to be seen.
It was a wide open shot. Real Starwell will dribble it down. Looking, making a dribbling move. And we'll go for the three, and it'll go out.
Rebound by Gotts. Gotts over to Scott, back to Bauer. Now Bauer taking it up. Bauer calling play. The screen by Scott, not very effective. Now trying to pull the foul, and she will gain the foul. So now Bauer going to the line. Sand Creek leading 19-14, a very low-scoring game tonight with 5:29 remaining in the third quarter. Foul on Mackenzie Reen.
Her third. They'll have to keep her out of foul trouble from now on.
Bauer with her first free throw attempt is up, and it is good. It is now 19-15. Bauer now up to shoot her second free throw. Bauer's shot is up, and it is good. Bounced around and in. So now it's 19-6.
Quick pass to Brielle Startwell for the inbound as she makes a fast dribbling move.
Britton Deerfield playing trap full court defense.
Which will be passed to Mackenzie Ream, which is passed to Kay Bench. Kay for the three, and it goes in. Nothing but net.
Now they're capitalizing off those threes now, that what they needed to do in the second half. Britton Deerfield now down 16-22 in the second half with 5 minutes remaining. Bauer up top. Looking.
Number 10.
Out to Langmeyer. Langmeyer for three. To answer back, no good, but rebound by Gotts. Gotts over to Bauer, but back to Gotts. Now over to Langmeyer. Langmeyer up top. Rolling over into the corner. And it is knocked out of bounds. Sand Creek possession.
Meg Saren is playing very good defense on Bowerman tonight, keeping her in front of her and keeping her from driving to the paint. Rails making a dribbling move. Opening for an opening, passes it to number 12, which passes it back to Brielle. Brielle picks up her dribble, passes it back to Hunter, which she regains her dribble again. Brielle's looking for an open three, which drives to the thing and will draw the foul.
It was blocked initially, but they called the foul now. So Brielle will now shoot her free throws. Foul.
Brielle Starwell is Sand Creek's highest free throw shooter.
The foul was on Mariah Gotts, the senior.
First free throw will go in. Hunter White is out, and number 10, Meg Sand, will come in, and number 22 will come in for Mackenzie Reed, number 14. Brielle will make both free throws, making the score 24-16 with 3:57 left in the third.
Bauer now taking it up across midcourt. Bauer inside to Alcock. Alcock will get the ball back and lays it in, bodying up Sand Creek, as that could be a problem.
Number two, Brielle Startwell will dribble it down for the Aggies. Looking for a three, and Kay Bench finds one and cashes it.
Impressive three by Sand Creek, as now they're leading by nine. Bauer now taking it up, trying to regain her team. Bauer over to Loesch, back to Bauer. Bauer over to Scott. Scott looking for a shot but can't get it. Langmeyer inside to Alcock. Alcock bodying up, misses. Rebound is Scott, but Scott can't lay it in.
Number 20, Kay Benj, gets a rebound and dribble is down court. Number 21 from Patriots try giving a back tip. Kaylee gives it to Brielle. Brielle makes a dribbling move and will get the layup.
Oh my, what a move by Sartwell. Bauer now taking it up. Bauer out to Loesch. Loesch looks like she'll be fouled. As Langmeyer to inbound the ball.
That's Brielle's Startwell's first foul for the whole game with only 2:41 seconds left in the third.
Langmeyer inbounds it to Scott. Scott almost with a backcourt violation. Screen set by Bauer and it's tipped and turnover.
Number 10, Meg Theron will get the steal, passes it back to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Brielle looks to start the offense again. Brielle makes a dribbling move, passes to number 14, Mackenzie Ream. Mackenzie Ream will airball it.
And it is saved by Sand Creek.
Pass to number 30, Grace Francoeur, which is passed to number 2, Brielle Startwell. Grace Francoeur will dive on the floor to save the ball again. But Mackenzie Ream will hit it out of bounds.
As Scott to inbound the ball to Bauer, as Britton Deerfield needs to get something going as they are down by 11 with 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Pass to Siren. Scott in the paint, can't get it, but rebound, can't put it back, is Loesch. And it's a loose ball, but it's a jump ball now.
Sand Creek will receive the ball. Number 30, Grace Francoeur will go out, and number 20, Kay Benj will come in. Brielle Startwell is going to inbound it to Kay Benj, which is going to pass it back. Kay Benj has started her her three-point shooters tonight. She's made two of them in this quarter, which will help make this game. Mackenzie Reamer will receive the ball, looking around. All the girls making moves. She passes it. She actually starts dribbling it. Makes a dribbling move. And we'll pass it to Brielle Startwell, which will attack for a layup, which gives it to Meg Theron. And Meg will make the two.
Brent Deerfield now leaned by 13 as Bauer trying to get him right back in the game. Screen by Alcock. Bauer out to Alcock for three. Long one, and it rolls out.
Kay Benj will get the rebound. It will go right to the other side, but misses her layup with Meg Theron getting the rebound, which will turn into a junk ball.
Britton Deerfield will retain possession. Scott to inbound it to Bauer. 51.6 seconds remaining on the clock. Bauer now up. Bauer getting the screen by Alcock, doesn't use it, drive, floats it up, no good. And it is rebound by Scott. Scott for three, no good.
Hunter White will get the rebound, which passes it to Brielle Startwell. Brielle Startwell quickly heads down court.
25 seconds remaining.
Sand Creek will be looking for a quick shot, just enough to get the time to run out. Brielle Startwell will make a move, and it'll go off of the Patriots. It was a kickball. Kay Benj will throw it inbounds. Gracie Gallagher has entered the game for Mackenzie Ream. Pass to Kay Benj, and she will make the three.
She is on fire. Brent Deerfield trying to get the last shot. 2 seconds to shoot. Couldn't pull it off, as at the end of the third quarter, Sand Creek leading 34-18 as you're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
Of all the things you've done with your bike, donating it to Goodwill may be the most incredible of all. Your donations help fund job placement and training for people in your community, which means your stuff can be more powerful than you think. Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back to LSN. In the third quarter, K-Benj was on fire, shooting threes like they were nothing. BD has trailed, only scoring few points in the third quarter, with Sand Creek scoring over close to 20 points just in the third. Sand Creek, if they keep up this flow of offense, they should end up winning this game if BD cannot stop them. The major threats right now will be Mackenzie Ream, Meg Saren, Brielle Startwell, and Kaylee Benj. Those are the seniors that Coach Benj is expecting a lot out of. Kay Benj will throw it in, starting to Brielle Startwell. Brielle will head down court, making dribbling moves. Kay Benj will screen, open up Brielle, which passes it to Kay. Benj will dribble, and it'll go out on Patriots.
Patriots playing pretty good defense, but cannot stop those threes.
Will be passed into McKenzie, which will be passed in, which is shot all the way around. Pass back to Startwell. Startwell makes a dribbling moon and will misses it. And we miss.
Rebound by Scott. Gets it to Bauer. Bauer now quickly taking up court. Out to Langmeyer, and bang, hits the three, trying to pick up the pace for Britton Deerfield.
The ball was in before Patriots defense got on them. That's what Sand Creek will have to do if they want to get the ball in. Startwell looking for the offense to start. Many cuts made. Startwell picks up her thing, but will pass it to Benj. Benj dribbles around, making a thing, and it will go off BD's hands.
And it's tipped off of Scott. Josalia Scott, to be precise.
Benj will pass it in again. Will be given to Meg Saren. Meg makes a dribbling move, but did not work.
And it's stolen by Bauer. Bauer into Gotts. Gotts no good. Saren, or Laren, back. And puts it in.
Sand Creek will really have to start boxing out on all the shots if they want to stay in this game to keep up their lead.
That was Maggie Loesch with the roll-in.
Given to K-Benj. K-Benj makes a move. We'll pass it to Startwell for the three, and it will not go in.
Scott with the rebound. Out to Bauer. Bauer now taking it up quickly. Up to Langmeyer. Langmeyer inside to Gotts. Gotts getting the contact and drawing the foul. So now Gotts will take her free throws.
It looks like it was called on Mackenzie Ream. That's her fourth in the fourth quarter. They need to keep her in to stop all those girls.
It's getting a little bit scary. They might need to, stop them.
It looks like they're going to bring Grace Francor in for Mackenzie Ream.
First free throw is no good. With 6 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, Sand Creek leads 34-23, up by 11. Gotts will shoot her second free throw here. Gotts shoots it up, and it will roll out.
Hunter White will get the rebound, which passes it back to Brielle Startwell.
Misses both free throws. That could be detrimental.
Real looks to make a dribbling move, but will draw the foul.
She'll draw the blocking foul down on the baseline.
Curl. KK.
Sand Creek will inbound it underneath their own basket. Hunter makes a good move and will score.
Britton Deerfield cannot allow to make those pretty often, especially not in the fourth quarter. Bauer now taking it up. Bauer over to Loesch. Loesch driving baseline, can't find anybody. Into Alcock, misses, it's over to Langmeier. Langmeier drives and will miss the lay-in. Rebound, Loesch. Loesch will lay it in. So now that will make it an 11-point game with 5:25 remaining in the fourth.
Startwell's just fast enough to throw off Beattie's defense, literally.
And it's stolen by Bauer at the baseline. Bauer now taking up. Ooh, hard screen by Loesch. Bauer now taking it up. Bauer now getting the screen from Loesch. Bauer up top. Trying to find Langmeier. Langmeier out for three. It is up and no good.
Grace Francoeur will get the rebound and passes it to Brielle Startwell. They are keeping hard defense on Brielle Startwell. They don't want her to make another dribbling move. And she gets past her. Passes it to Benj.
And timeout by Sand Creek. As we're going to cut it to break, you're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
So they say it's a man's world? I don't see anybody's name on it.
While they were doing their thing, we slowly changed all.
Today, women can do anything men can do. And there's one thing we're even better at.
There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
Welcome back to LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports, as Sand Creek to inbound the ball.
Sand Creek will look for Brielle Startwell, but she did get open. Brielle will get it in the backside of the court. BD is hoping for a steal, but Brielle makes it, given to Kay, and will not make it in. Grace Francoeur will get the rebound, given to Benj. Benj will miss the layup.
Bauer stumbling, and it will be out on Bauer. As Sand Creek will retain possession.
Benj will be passing in again, hoping to get to start well.
And that's a 5-second call on Sand Creek as Britton Deerfield will cause the inbound turnover. Scott to inbound it to Bauer.
Britton Deerfield's defense is heating up in the fourth quarter, hoping to come back and win the game.
That's what they need. Bauer out to Langmeier. Langmeier wide open for three. Bang! Langmeier now hits her second three of the night to make it an 8-point game.
Kay Benj will dribble down the court, making a fast dribbling move, and will pass it to Gracie Gallagher. Gracie Gallagher passes it to Brielle Startwell, almost a turnover, and will not make the layup.
Bauer now court getting pressed, and will be Britton Deerfield will call a timeout. As we're going to cut it to break, you're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
Go for a mouthful, go for the fun.
Go for cake.
For everyone. Just one stack is what it takes. And it's go for cakes. Open wide, stuff your face. There's always room for more go for cakes. Empty the box, they're reload. Eat those go for cakes till you. Explode.
Exercised lately.
Till you explode.
Don't let E. coli mosh with your food. An estimated 3,000 Americans die from a foodborne illness each year. So always separate raw meat from vegetables. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back to LSN as Sand Creek leads in the fourth quarter with 3:44 left to go. Score is 36-28. Sand Creek has not ran into foul troubles other than Mackenzie Ream, which it looks like they are bringing her back in. Sand Creek has three fouls, and Britton Deerfield has two.
Sand Creek leading by eight with 3:44 remaining in the fourth quarter. Do you think they can hold on to this?
I think they could if their defense stays strong and they find ways to penetrate BDs.
Scott wide open for the mid-range and rolls around and out.
Hunter White will catch the rebound given back to Brielle Startwell. Brielle Startwell makes good dribbling moves as Bauer tries getting the reach, or not the reach, as she's reaching. Given to Hunter White. Hunter White will have it go through her feet. Brielle Startwell for the three and cash.
Bang. Great three and a very much needed three for the Fighting Aggies as Bauer taking it up to number 15. Creek, as Creek driving baseline, trying to find something, and looks like they'll be fouled. Foul on Brielle Startwell. As Langmeyer to inbound it for Britton Deerfield.
They're bringing back Mackenzie Ream for Grace Francor.
Creek inbounds it to Scott, but it will be tipped out. So Britton Deerfield will retain possession. Inbound to Alcock. Alcock can't get it. Rebound by Startwell.
Startwell looks to waste time off the clock as a foul is drawn.
Foul on Megan Bauer, her first foul of the night. Britton Deerfield's third team foul.
Passed in to number 14, Mackenzie Ream. Brielle Startwell will be given the ball again.
And it's intercepted. The pass is intercepted by Langmeyer. Langmeyer driving and will be fouled in the process as Britton Deerfield will retain possession. Creek to inbound it. Creek looking up top to Alcock. Alcock turnaround jumper, no good. Rebound is Ream.
Ream gets trapped but passes it to Startwell. Startwell looks down court and no one's open. Passes it to Benj. Benj looks to make a dribbling move and gives it to number 12, Hunter White.
Passed up an open three look, probably just trying to waste time.
And it'll go out of bounds on the Patriots. Benj will pass it in.
As Britton Deerfield making substitutions, Loesch and Gotts in for Alcock and Creek.
It'll be go off number 14, Mackenzie's Ream's hands, and BD will retain recession.
Scott to inbound it to Bauer. Heard that plenty of times tonight. Bauer not taking it up court. Heard that a lot too. Over to Scott. Scott for a three, no good. Rebound, Gotts.
Looks like there was a foul called.
Sand Creek will get the ball back. As Sand Creek will call a timeout with 1:54 remaining as we're going to go to break. You're watching LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
There's just one place where students are students first, and athletics are played with purpose and perspective. That place is your local high school. High school sports offer more than the joy of competition. Studies show that student athletes are also likely to enjoy greater levels of achievement in other areas of their lives, including academics. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play or even what you wear. You just need to be there. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
Welcome back to LSN as There's 154 seconds left in the fourth quarter as Sand Creek leads 39-28.
Britton Deerfield trying to make a late comeback.
Sand Creek will throw the ball in, and it'll go to number 20, Benj. Benj will pass it to number 2, Startwell. Startwell makes a move down court. Screen set by number 4. Oh, and Startwell will fall.
Hard foul by Gotts.
Benj will pass it in, looking to find an open person before the 5 seconds runs out. And it'll go to Ream. Ream will make a move.
Great post moves. Great post moves by Ream. That's what they've needed all game long. And it counts right now. Bauer now taking it up court. Bauer trying to make a hesitation. Nice spin move out to Langmeier. Langmeier over to Scott. Scott for a contested three. What can't bank in. Rebound, Sand Creek.
Startwell will get the rebound, dribbles down court as she is almost fouled by BD. And she is fouled by BD. Benj will throw it in on the sideline of Sand Creek's basket. Ball is given to Ream. Ream gives it back to Benj, and another foul is called. BD is starting to foul. BD has 7 fouls, and Sand Creek only has 4. BD is now 1-1 if they foul again.
Langmeier with the foul. Sand Creek to shoot their free throws. Is up and no good, and it will go off Reen's arms as Britton Deerfield will get the possession. Scott to inbound it to Bauer. Bauer now taking up court with 1:10 remaining. And looks like
a foul. Patriots will get the foul, an offensive foul. This is her second or third foul of the night.
Foul on Langmeier.
It'll be an offensive foul, so Sand Creek will not shoot as another foul is called.
Another foul called on Bauer. Now, it looks like Britton Deerfield is now playing the fouling game at the end of this game, trying to have some type of comeback.
Rael Startwell is at the line. Last time she was at the line, she made both of her shots. Rael will make her first free throw, giving her her next one. And it will spin out of the rim with BD getting the rebound.
Langmeier dribbling up the court real quick. Scott is blocked by Reen from behind. What a block.
Which another foul will be called. It looks like on BD again.
Less than 1 minute remaining in the quarter as Sand Creek now leading by 14. It looks like it might be too little too late for the Britton Deerfield Patriots.
Now if BD fouls, they will Sand Creek, no matter what, will shoot 2 free throws since they have reached the bonus.
The double bonus.
Double bonus. And Brielle Start will make her fifth free throw of the night. And Startwell makes her free throw again.
Quick inbound to Bauer. Bauer now taking up court quickly, trying to find a shot, can't draw the foul, and they will now foul Sand Creek again.
BD is really running into foul trouble at this point in the game with only 50 seconds left. They're trying to get any they can. And it looks like BD's coach will get a technical foul.
Fifty seconds remaining on the clock. Sand Creek to shoot 2 free throws. Sand Creek leading 44-28. With a technical foul, BD coach. Now, if he gets one more, he's out of the game, but it wouldn't really matter with 50 seconds remaining. And that is the first of the night. First technical foul of the night.
And Star will make her free throw.
As Britton Deerfield will call a timeout here with 50 seconds remaining. As we're going to cut to break. You're watching LSN. You're home for the Lenawee Sports.
This new dad is picturing a treehouse in the sky, but he's ignoring the instructions.
Good luck, big guy.
His kids know that he's building without a clue. Never been so good with nails and glue. Now we're trapped inside a box. I hope Mom knows what to do.
Mom!
See, you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
Connor is struggling in school.
Finding lowest airfare to Istanbul.
Why don't you understand me?
I do. This is what it feels like for kids with learning and attention issues. Redirecting to understood.org.
And we're back. Startwell will make her last technical free throw of the night. And Sand Creek will get the ball on the sideline.
That's what happens with the technical foul, and it can be very detrimental to the game's momentum.
Startwell will get the ball in. Bauer will foul again.
As the crowd is arguing, that they're saying that should have been a technical on Bauer. Startwell now to shoot two more free throws. First one is up and good. She has been very good with her free throws tonight. I can only recall her missing once.
Startwell has made, she's actually Sand Creek's highest free throw shooter on the team.
Second one is up and misses. That's her second miss of the night. Bauer now taking it up court quickly over to Scott. Scott drives and she will be fouled as now Scott to shoot two free throws.
Sand Creek has actually been advancing their lead by the free throws they have made.
Inbound to Alcock, and Alcock will lay it in. With 35 seconds remaining, Britton Deerfield will foul once again.
Sand Creek's defense will go back as Kaylee shoots the free throws. And she will make her first one. And will miss her second.
Rebound by Alcock out to Bauer. Bauer now taking it out court. Trying to do something, almost traveled, and now will turn over, and a hard foul by Britton Deerfield.
And it looks like it will be a technical called.
Absolutely, shoving Sartwell to the ground. Sartwell really taking a beating in these last couple minutes of the game with some hard fouls by Britton Deerfield, some rough play.
And it looks like a lot of subs will be coming in for BD. Start will miss this free throw. And will make her last one.
With 26 seconds remaining on the clock, I think it's too little too late as the Aggies lead by 19 points. They're really pulling away in this fourth quarter as St. Creek will now call a timeout to discuss some strategy. As we're going to throw it to break. You're watching LSN. You're home for the Lenawee Sports.
And we're out.
You got plans?
You bet.
$50 million Americans struggle with hunger, but we can do something about it.
Excuse me.
What's going on?
Dinner.
Please join me in helping put food on their tables. Together, we can feed America.
You guys keep going. I'm gonna get the plates.
Plates!
Find your local food bank at feedingamerica.org/hunger.
This job looks perfect. It says you need a high school diploma. You've got one of those, right?
Skip the drama. Get your diploma.
I got that.
Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
And we're back on LSN as Sand Creek will throw the ball in with 26 seconds left in the game. She looks for someone to get open and will pass it to number 22, Helena Dickerson, which will throw it out of bounds.
Scott will inbound it to number 21, Loesch, as Loesch will try to drive, finding a seam, and is blocked by Reen.
And it will go out on the Aggies, leading the Patriots to get the ball at their own basket.
As number 24, Brittany Evers, will come in the game, out to Loesch. Loesch.
Foul is called with 13 seconds left in the game.
As Maggie Reen with her fifth foul, and she'll be subbed out most likely for the rest of the game as she's getting a standing ovation. Britton Deerfield inbound, and it's a jump ball. Jump ball from USA. So Britton Deerfield to inbound. Inside to Scott. Scott can't hang on to it as
Dickerson
Sand Creek.
The ball to number 30, K Bench, and Brielle Startwell will run out of time in this game, leading the Aggies to win the game tonight.
As the Aggies pull away with the 19-point victory, 49-30 over the Britton Deerfield Patriots. As we're going to throw it to break, you're watching LSN, your home for Lenawee Sports.
You're doing great. We're going to try this again, okay?
Okay.
Wheels, pedals, handlebar, brakes. Sit up straight, keep your weight in the center, keep your eyes on the road, hands on the grips, button to seat. If we feel ourselves falling, what do?
Just keep pedaling.
Good girl. Now remember, it's all about balance and steering. Steer with your hands, steer with your body. Steer into the corners and you stay out of trouble. And the bell's your buddy, so go ahead and ding that. All right, ready? Here we go. Pedal, honey, pedal. Go, you're a bike rider.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
The odds of becoming a successful NASCAR driver, 1 in 125 billion. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism, 1 in 68. I'm Jamie McMurray. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
Coach, even though it got a little catty there at the end, how do you think your game went as a whole?
I think our game plan went all the way, and I understand it. You know, I've been there before. You know, they expected to come in here and, you know, do well against us, and you know, our kids showed up. They showed up tonight. They did what they're capable of, and they went at them. And so, you know, it got a little catty, but you know what? They're a tough team. We're a tough team, too. You know what I mean? It's good for girls basketball to watch kids scrap. You know what I mean? That's just me. You know what I mean? So I'm okay with that. I got a lot of respect for BD, a lot of respect for their coach. They were just playing hard, and he wanted his kids to play hard to the end. So, and our kids, you know, they worked hard, and they shut them down all night, and that can be frustrating.
Is this what you expect to see out of your team within the district?
This is exactly what I expect to see. This is exactly what we know that we're capable of. Now we just have to come out and do it. And they're more than capable of winning a district, but they have to play like they did tonight. They were tough.
Congratulations on the win, Coach, and we hope to see you do good in the district.
Welcome back to LSN's postgame show, as we have our star player, Brielle Startwell, here. As what does this win say for your team?
It says a lot. Like, we had really bad trouble with rebounding, and we came back on defense and got us a win.
How do you think you could use this momentum going into your next games?
Well, the game plan is to just try to win all the games that we can, but districts is what really counts, so that's what we're going for and striving for.
For the entire Lenawee Sports Crew, I'm Hannah saying thank you for watching this evening. The Aggies win tonight, beating the Patriots by a final score of 49-30.
In our next game, the Lenawee Sports Crew is back on the map as we arrive in Tiger Country as the state district tournament gets underway. We would like to remind you to get connected to LISD TV on Facebook and Twitter for LSN's upcoming broadcast. Also, check us out on YouTube and subscribe to LISD TV's channel for this and our other full game broadcasts. This has been a presentation of LSN, your home for the Lenawee Sports.
Head, and I don't think that was an accident.
We've got a tie atop the LCAA standings.
Count that baby in a foul.
The first time they've been there in 61 years. Morenci is going to the President Center.
And I think this is pretty much over.
Blissfield Royals, district champions.